Princesslandia is represented by two separate and not remotely equally important types of people. The royal princes and princesses who have been celebrated for almost 100 years, and the villains who tried to kill them. These are their stories. Thanks for helping me with the castle cleanups tonight, Blondie. I really appreciate it.
No problem, Mr. White. I know you were stuck working on the toilet in Castle 4 for quite a while tonight.
Yeah. You know, I don't think those dwarves counted on the beast when they put the plumbing in this place.
You can say that again, Mr. White.
You know, I don't think the dwarves counted on the beast when... I got it,
Mr. White, I got it. You know, I used to work with a Mr. White.
Yeah? Did you like him?
Not in the end. You know, it's funny, his actual name wasn't Mr. White, it was... Oh. Oh my. Mr. White, you better come take a look at this.
Oh my God. I wasn't expecting a call this late.
Neither was I. I had just put my bunny slippers on.
I mean, my bunny pajamas.
Wait, that's not better, is it?
No, not really. Let's go see what's going on.
Sorry we're late, Chief. We had a slipper issue to deal with.
A slipper issue, huh?
Yeah, I've been there.
Bunny slippers?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what's going on?
Somebody has stolen the magic mirror.
The magic mirror?
Dear Lord. Imagine the questions somebody could have answered if they have possession of that thing.
I know, right? That's why we've got to find it right away. I mean, imagine if they asked the mirror about my internet search history.
I don't want that. I mean, I was just wondering if they had dresses in my size. I wasn't actually going to buy one.
Well, we're on the case now, sir.
That's right, you are.
I need you boys to canvass for witnesses, establish a time frame and motive, and bring me a suspect. You got 48 hours before the trail runs cold, so start with the last person to see that mirror on the wall.
Yes, sir. Understood. All right, you boys. Get to it.
Looks like it's going to be a long night. How'd we draw the short straw?
It's not a short straw. It's a glass case.
Well, like Michael Jackson said, I guess we're looking for the man in the mirror.
Yeah. Well, it might take a miracle to find this thing.
Survey says...
We can't both do the Zener.
You're right. That's my bad. Sorry.
Well, if it isn't Mr. Yoga. How's it going, Tarzan?
Can I help you, gentlemen?
You tell us. Where were you last night, Tarzan?
Last night, Jane and I were at the castle for a little bit, then we went down to the Goofy Tavern to watch a football game.
Football doesn't start for another month, Tarzan.
Football. Not American football, actual football. I believe you people call it bananas.
Oh, you mean soccer?
Soccer, bananas, football, the most popular sport in the world. Whatever you want to call it.
And how long do you think you guys were gone?
I don't know, probably a little over 2 hours.
And you didn't notice the mirror was gone when you got back.
No, we actually didn't know until Walter woke us up in the middle of the night.
And you didn't hear anything?
No.
Is that because you stole it?
It was my mirror. I won it in the paintball game. Why would I steal my own mirror? God, that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
Is it?
Actually, it is. Yeah, I hate to call you out like that, but it's pretty stupid. You know, as soon as I said it out loud, I heard it, and it did sound like a really dumb theory, I must say. It sounded really dumb when I said it. You know, instead of talking to the guy who won the magic mirror in the paintball game, maybe you ought to be talking to the person who set up the paintball game just to acquire the mirror. Did you ever think about that?
Oh, yeah. Cicely Tyson, right?
No, the evil queen, you morons.
Oh, we're morons? Really? We're morons? If we're morons, how come we're gonna go talk to the evil queen right now?
Because I told you to.
Whatever. Let's go.
Morons.
Little man on the wall. Who's the fast of them all? Feel free to answer. Anytime.
Hello, queen.
Oh, hello, boys. What a unpleasant surprise this is.
You like mirrors, huh?
You know I do.
You like stealing them?
Well, I've never had to steal a mirror before. After all, I was the queen. I could have a mirror any time I asked for it. How can I help you gentlemen tonight?
Well, for starters, you can help us by telling us where you were last night.
Last night. Well, I took in some of the football match at the Goofy Tavern. After that, I stopped by Hans to help him with his latest song for Merida. And then I was home and asleep by 10:30. Why do you ask?
Sounds like you keep a pretty tight schedule.
Well, that's one of the side effects of being queen. Schedule was everything. That and an iron fist.
You know, queen, people in Princesslandia do life in prison for the crime we suspect you of.
Crime? What crime? I've committed no crime. What is this all about? What are you talking about? What is this about?
Isn't that interesting? Here I am talking about life in prison, and you haven't even asked me what this is all about.
What? I literally just asked you that question.
Yeah, she did. She just asked you that exact question.
Oh, she did?
Oh, you know, I had my next line so locked and loaded that I wasn't even paying attention to what she was saying. Yeah, you should probably pay more attention. Okay. Noted. Duly noted.
Will you please tell me what this is all about?
The magic mirror was stolen last night. We think maybe you had something to do with it.
The mirror? No.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No!
Yes!
For the love of God, it was stolen. Oh, no, not the mirror. I love that mirror. Please tell me you know where it is. If it's okay, do you have any leads? Do you have any suspects?
Well, so far, you're kind of our only suspect, really.
Oh, I didn't steal the mirror. I love that mirror. I would never bring any harm to that mirror. Please tell me you'll find that mirror. Please tell me now you'll find that mirror.
I'm starting to think maybe she didn't do it. Yeah, I'm getting that, too. Plus, she's crying now, and I don't like to be around people who are crying.
Oh, it's the worst, right? I mean, that's the part of the job I hate the most, when people cry.
All right, queen, we're going to get out of here. Yeah, we're going to leave. But hey, queen, you stay clean.
Clean queen. Hilarious. Nailed it.
These interviews really aren't getting us anywhere. We're no closer to solving this case than when we started.
I know, right? Everybody just seems so innocent.
Yeah. What's your gut tell you?
My gut? Well, honestly, my gut's telling me I should not have had that Indian food last night.
No, I mean your gut, like on the case. You know, your gut, your instincts. What's it telling you?
Oh, on the case. You know, it's still focused on the Indian food. It was a big mistake.
Well, here's what I think we ought to do. Let's round up the usual suspects and shake the tree. See if anything falls out.
Interesting. Usual suspects, shake the tree, see if anything falls out. Like apples, you mean?
Yeah, exactly like apples.
Yeah. You know, I used to steal apples.
Yeah, I know.
Steal the magic mirror. Tell me now. Confess. Just confess right now. Who was it?
Who was it?
Nope, not me. No, of course not.
The magic what? Shoot. You know, I really thought that would work.
Yeah, I had my doubts, actually. You know what we should do? We should interrogate them individually and see if anyone slips up.
Ooh, individually. Yeah, I like that. Let's put them in the box. Absolutely.
This is grade A baloney.
Oh, grade A baloney? You mean the highest quality of baloney? Is that what you're saying?
This has got to be really embarrassing for you guys. Don't tell us what it's like. Where's the mirror, Gaston?
What mirror?
The magic mirror, Barge Boy.
Barge Boy? Okay. Is that a compliment or an insult?
You know it's an insult. Nobody wants to be a barge.
It's interesting, though. You want to hear what your buddy told us? He told us a different story altogether.
What buddy?
Gaston, Jafar. Gaston told us a whole nother story altogether.
Yeah? Was that the one about the 4 dozen eggs?
No. It was the one about how you stole the magic mirror.
Oh, really? Sounds like a good piece of fiction. Is it in paperback yet?
Don't talk to me about paperback.
Where's the mirror, Jafar? Where's the mirror?
I don't have your mirror, imbeciles.
Can you guys hear me in the back okay? Huh? Can you hear me in the back? Hello? Hello?
I want my lawyer. You know, I have both your badges for this.
We know you were involved, Maleficent. Just tell us where the mirror is.
You've got nothing on me.
Really?
You know, we can put you in Princesslandia the night of the burglary.
Really?
I live in Princesslandia. Did you put that together yourselves, Einsteins, or do you have a team of monkeys working around the clock on this one? Do you know what happens to you if you get caught stealing in Princesslandia?
I don't know. I go work for DreamWorks.
DreamWorks would never have you! Not a thief like you. Are you going to charge me?
I'll charge you when I'm good and ready.
Charge me with what?
With the theft of the stolen magic mirror.
I used the force. What do I need a magic mirror for?
Oh, because you're a greedy villain, that's why. A greedy, greedy villain.
You know, I've been walking around here with the same face, with the same name. Why didn't you just ask me?
It was your mistake, not mine.
Don't tell us about our mistakes.
It was your mistake.
Did you steal the magic mirror?
There's a mirror that's magic? What does it do, like card tricks? Have you been talking to the man in the mirror?
There's a man in the mirror?
We know you'd like to ask the mirror a lot of questions, like maybe which princesses would like to go on a date with you.
He can do that? You guys gotta hook me up. I would love to have that information.
Where is the magic mirror?
There's a mirror that's magic?
That man might know less than anyone I've ever talked to.
Yeah, he knows nothing. Nothing.
Oh, I just got a text from the chief. Looks like he's got some new information. He wants to talk to us right away.
Thank goodness, we are getting nowhere on this case. Like, absolutely nowhere.
Yeah, it's pretty fun wearing these jackets though, right?
Oh my god, so much fun. So fun.
So, how's the investigation going?
Not good. Not good at all. Like, we have gotten nowhere so far. We're just grasping at straws here. It's really embarrassing. I feel like we're really bad cops.
Well, I mean, you're not cops.
Yeah, but I mean, we're dressed like them.
Well, anyway, we just had a major break in the case. We found a major piece of evidence at the crime scene. Do you guys recognize this hat?
Oh my goodness, yes, of course I do. That's Christoph's hat. Flynn, do you see that? That's Christoph's hat, right?
Yeah, that's definitely Christoph's hat. He wears it all the time.
Who's Christoph? Seriously? You don't... Do you pay attention to anyone here?
Not really, no. Anyways, bring this Christoph in for questioning. He's our lead suspect as of right now, since we can place him at the scene of the crime.
Will do. Absolutely, we'll bring him in. Man, did we need a break. Again, I feel like we have been really bad cops on this one.
Again, you're not cops.
Maybe not, but we dress like cops, and we look really cool while we're doing it.
Yeah, that's true. That's a good point.
Yeah, that is a good point.
Captain thinks we look cool. That's awesome. All right, let's bring Christoph in and ask him a few questions.
Yeah, absolutely. Let's ask him what his hat was doing at the crime scene. Let's also ask him, like, where he got the hat, because, you know, it's kind of cool, and I could use a new hat.
Oh, really? Do you not like your little tiny hat anymore?
You know what, Flynn? Just stop.
All right, Christoph, we're going to need some answers, and we're going to need some answers right now.
But first off, why is your fiancé here again?
I'm here because you cannot legally question Kristoff alone if he requests the presence of his fiancée.
Yeah, what she said.
That can't be right. No, that doesn't sound right at all. I don't think that's right. We are cops. Can't we just throw her out of here?
You're not cops.
Well, we're dressed like cops. Fine, she can stay. No big deal. Anyways, Kristoff, we found your hat at the scene of the crime.
You can't prove that.
What do you mean we can't prove it? Yep, we found the hat there.
Objection.
No, there's no objections.
Yes, there is.
Look, listen, Kristoff, we found your hat there. You were obviously there. How do you explain your presence there?
You don't have to answer that.
No, it's okay, babe. I'll cooperate. Oh, you know, I did go over there earlier to see if Tarzan wanted to play some racquetball. And I couldn't find him anywhere, so I was just kind of waiting around. And while I was there, I ended up falling asleep in a ray of sunlight. A ray of sunlight? That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
No, it's actually true. I've seen it. It's quite adorable.
Yeah, it's really adorable. All right. So you fell asleep in a ray of sunlight. Mm-hmm. Did you hear anything while you were napping?
You don't have to answer that.
No, I'll help. You know, I did hear something. I thought it was part of my dream, but now that I think about it, I think it was real. I heard someone singing.
You really don't have to answer these.
You heard someone singing. Was it a man or a woman?
You don't have to answer that, babe.
No, I think it was a man, but it was such a beautiful voice.
You know, it could have been a beautiful voice.
It could have been a man or a woman.
You really don't have to say that.
All right, here's what we're going to do. We're going to set up that lineup again, and we're going to have all of them sing. And we're going to hope that Kristoff can recognize the voice. How's
overruled.
That sound? What?
Yeah, overruled.
No, you can't overrule. We're just coming up with a plan.
Case dismissed.
Get out of here. Let's just go do the lineup.
Objection.
You're the worst. All right. Now, do you remember what the song was the guy was singing when you heard him? Yeah, I think it was I Want It That Way. Backstreet Boys. I'm familiar with it. Okay. Number one, can you sing the opening to I Want It That Way?
Really? Okay. You are my fire.
Number two, keep it going.
The one desire.
Number three.
Believe when I say.
Number four.
I want it that way.
Tell me why.
Ain't nothing but a heartache.
Tell me why.
Nothing but a mistake.
Now number five.
I never wanna hear you say.
Woo!
I want it that way.
Oh, chills. Literal chills. Oh, it was number five. I'd recognize that beautiful voice anywhere. Oh my God, I totally forgot about that part. All right, Style Boy. Let's talk about the night the magic mirror was stolen. Yeah, I heard about that, huh? I guess I was in the castle that night. That's crazy to think about. It really is. It's crazy. Is it? Is it really that crazy? Well, I guess when you consider the world we live in these days, it's not that crazy. I mean, it's just kind of the sign of the times, you know? It's definitely not the same as it was, that's for sure. You're one of the last people we can place in the castle that night. We're thinking maybe you stole the mirror. Oh, come on, mates. Don't drag me down like that. Come on. I'm Harry Styles. I'm not a thief. That's not the story of my life. I've got the world by its tail. Why would I ever steal anything? Come on. What were you doing in the castle that night? You know, I was over there talking to Jane. We were kind of catching up and talking about the old country a little bit. And then I called a car service, and I was waiting for the driver, and I just started singing a little bit, you know. I tried to keep my voice in shape, tried to keep it sounding like honey. Your voice does sound like honey. Thank you, mate. Thank you. But it doesn't just happen like that overnight. You know, I got to work at it. Tell us about the driver who picked you up. Well, there's not a whole lot I can tell you about him. You know, I try not to look drivers in the eye too much or talk to them because, you know, sometimes they get a little excited that they're picking up Harry Styles. So I try to do my own thing and leave him be. So I really didn't get a good look at him. I will say this. When he picked me up, I went outside to his car and he had to go inside the castle and use the bathroom, he said. So, you know, I had to wait like 20, 30 minutes for him like I wasn't Harry Styles. So that part was kind of strange. Interesting. Very interesting. All right, Harry, well, just so you know, Ali and I will be working this case to the end. We won't sleep until we figure out who stole that mirror, so you should be aware of that. Well, I appreciate that from you guys, I really do. You know, that's what makes you beautiful, it really is. All right, I guess that's all the questions we've got for you right now. Hang on, I've got a question for you. There's just a little something I've been working on, and I would like your professional opinion on it. All right,
One, two. And then Flynn comes in and I change up the tempo. Flynn comes in and it changes the song. He's looking at me like he thinks I'm an idiot. Looking at me like I'm always wrong. Why are you bringing me down, Flynn? Why are you bringing me down? Don't bring me down!
Okay, alright. Well, that took a lot out of me. It really did. Whew! Put my heart out there. Well, what'd you think, Harry? What'd you think?
It's not good, brother. It's not good at all.
Yeah.
Don't quit your day job.
I don't have a day job.
Oh, really? You should get a day job.
All right, well, at least we got a little information out of that interrogation. Is it me, or did a lot of that sound like poetry?
Yeah, it really did. Wait, are you including my song?
No, I am not. Here's what I think we should do, though. Let's call all the car ride services in Princesslandia and see if anything turns up.
Isn't there only one? Isn't it just the Jesus car service?
You know what, I think you might be right. We should order a ride off there. You know, I can't, though, because I've been banned from using that app. Do you have it?
I do not. I do not. I used to, but there were some complications, so
we should try to find someone who can order to ride off the app.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. Somebody with better credit, maybe.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So pretty much anybody?
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much anybody would work. Yep.
Hey, Captain. You got a minute?
Hello, detectives. Is there a reason you're interrupting me mid-soup?
Yeah, we need you to order us a ride off the Jesus car service app.
Why don't you just do it yourselves?
Well, my problem is credit, and Flynn's been banned, so we need you to do it.
If I do this, will you allow me to finish my soup and leave me be?
Yeah, of course we will. Of course we will. Wait, you know, unless... Captain, did you want to work this case with us by chance?
Do you guys need babysitting?
No, of course not. We just thought maybe you'd like to get out from behind that desk and get back in the field a little bit.
I'd rather finish my soup.
All right. Finish your soup, and then if you could order us a ride off the app, that'd be great. Oh, one more thing, Captain, one more thing. We wanted to go by code names on this investigation, so from now on, if you could call me Deathblade and then call Flynn Sidewinder, that would be great.
I will do no such thing.
We can give you a nickname, too. Would you like a nickname?
No, you can just continue to call me Captain Beast.
Okay, so Wet Blanket. You want to be called Wet Blanket?
Yeah, whatever. Can I finish my soup now?
Of course you can. Of course you can.
All right. I ordered a ride from Jesus' car service. I told him to pick us up here in this garden.
Good call. Good call. Everybody loves gardens. I bet nobody's ever had a bad experience in a garden, ever.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Hey, when he gets here, just try to play it cool.
What's that mean?
I always play it cool. I'm always cool. Yeah, you are.
I don't think I like your hesitation on that.
Oh, there he is. All right, play it cool.
Oh, really? You're going to tell me twice?
Yeah, just play it cool. Three times?
Gentlemen, is one of you Sidewinder?
Yeah, that's me.
All right, guys. Let's hop in the car and let's get to that trampoline park.
Trampoline park? Awesome!
Oh, wait, we're not actually going to the trampoline park, are we?
No. Play it cool.
Oh my god, how many times you gotta tell me that?
As many times as I have to.
So, Jesus, we actually won't be needing that ride at the trampoline park.
Aww.
Shh! Anyway, we actually have a few questions for you.
Oh, you have a few questions for me, huh? Okay. Ask away, I like questions.
Yeah, we have a few questions about your whereabouts a couple nights ago.
Oh, okay. Well, you know what? Let me grab my calendar out of the car, and I can tell you exactly where I was. Hang on a second.
Looks like we got a runner.
Yeah. Yeah, he's taking off. We should probably chase after him, right?
Yeah. He's wearing sandals. He's not going to get too far. We'll get him.
So, you boys have a few questions for me, do you?
Yeah, we've got quite a few questions, so make yourself comfortable.
Oh, I'm very comfortable.
Yeah, I can see that. First of all, why'd you run away from us?
Well, I don't like being ambushed in gardens. I have a pretty bad history with gardens, actually.
Oh, man, we really misjudged that.
Yeah, you should read my book.
Well, I have a question for you. When you go to write a soundtrack, like, say, Footloose, do they give you the script in advance, or do you just write the songs and they fit them into the movie?
I'm sorry, what are you saying right now?
Like the movie Footloose, when you wrote the soundtrack for it, how does that work exactly?
Oh, that wasn't me, that was Kenny Loggins.
Wait, that wasn't you? Wait, you guys aren't the same guy?
No, that's actually a common misconception. But Kenny wishes it was true, but I did not write that soundtrack.
Hey, look, I have a real question for you. Why did you steal the magic mirror, and where is it?
The magic mirror? I didn't steal the magic mirror. Why would I steal the magic mirror?
I don't know. Maybe you're afraid of the competition. If people are going to the magic mirror for answers, maybe they won't come to you so often.
Oh, no, I don't worry about that sort of thing. I'm not competitive when it comes to that. You know, I do my own thing, and if people dig it, they dig it. You know, I don't get competitive about it. No, people are going to do what they want, follow what they want. I'm not competitive about that at all.
But you picked up Harry Styles at that castle the night the mirror was stolen.
Harry Styles? No, I didn't pick up Harry Styles. I think I'd remember that. I'm a huge Harry Styles fan. In fact, is he still around? I would love an autograph of him.
He said he got a car ride service.
Well, maybe he did, but, you know, I'm not the only car ride service in Princesslandia.
I thought you were.
Oh, no, this other guy started up a rival business. He's actually been cutting into my business quite a bit. But no, he's around. So it was probably him. It wasn't me. I know I didn't pick up Harry Styles.
What can you tell us about this guy?
Oh, I don't know. I've seen him around a little bit. He's a big guy. He doesn't have much of a personality. Not a big vocabulary either.
Is it Maui?
Maui? No. God, no. You got Maui from that? No, Maui's full of personality. He's all personality. Plus, he's a demigod. I mean, we hang out at the same clubs and after parties all the time. No, it's not Maui. No, this guy, God, I really don't know what I can tell you that would help. He wears a leather jacket, I guess. I don't know how many leather jackets are around in Princesslandia. Oh, you know what? I don't know if this will help or not, but he's got like a half-human face and a half-robot face. You know, I don't know if that detail helps or not, but I did notice that.
Oh, all right. I think I know who you're talking about now. Okay.
Yeah, actually, if you guys could take him out of the picture, that would really benefit my my car ride service. You know, I don't like the competition. I thought you didn't care about competition. Well, not when it comes to faith and religion and, you know, the eternal afterlife. But when it comes to the car ride service, I get very competitive. You know, I'm very fierce about it. And this guy's really been hurting me. So if you could, you know, take him out, that would be great for me, personally.
All right, Jesus. Well, thanks for the information. I guess you're free to go.
Oh, I'm free to do anything I want. I am Jesus.
All right, just, you know, don't leave town anytime soon in case we have more questions for you.
No matter where I am, my child, you can always talk to the Jesus.
I meant in person.
Oh, okay, then I won't leave town. Yeah, good note.
Hey, Captain, we need one more favor from you.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. What is it now?
Is that the same bowl of soup? Isn't it cold? How do you eat cold soup?
This is my bowl of Jell-O. I usually enjoy it after my bowl of soup, usually in peace and quiet. What can I do for you gentlemen now?
We need another ride from a car service.
Another ride? How many rides will you be needing on this investigation?
Well, you got us the one before, and now we need another one, so I don't know, like five?
Five? Do you need a math tutor? Because we can provide one for you if you need.
No, I don't need a math tutor. We just need a ride. Can you get us the ride?
Yes, I'll get you the ride. But I need you gentlemen to close this investigation and find out who stole that magic mirror. Can you do that for me?
We are so close, Captain. We are so close. In fact, you should join us now. You should join us and help us finish this investigation.
I'd rather finish my Jell-O.
Fine. Finish your Jell-O. Can you just get us a ride, please, Captain Wet Blanket?
Yes, Detectives Ali and Flynn. I will get you a ride.
It's Deathblade and Sidewinder. Why can't you do the things that we want to do when we think of things? And, you know, we try to do cool things and you don't like our things and then we're different things. It's all about the things.
Do you need an English tutor? Because we can provide one for you if you need.
No English tutors. Just a ride, sir. Just a ride. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Captain. Captain Wet Blanket.
Here's the plan. I'll take the ride in the car service and you hang back and be my backup. Just in case I get in any trouble.
I'm guessing that'll be pretty much right away.
Yeah, it'll probably be right away, because I usually screw things up right away. So, you have to be my backup, okay?
Yeah, I'll be ready at any time. Okay, all right. Oh, no, there he is. Okay, you're my backup. I'm going to get in the car now. Okay, all right, let's go.
Hey, man, thanks for the ride. I really appreciate it. I bet you love being a car service driver, huh?
It's okay.
Yeah, I bet it's pretty exciting. Hey, I heard you picked up Harry Styles the other night. That had to be pretty thrilling.
I really can't talk about who I pick up due to driver-rider privileges.
Yeah, I understand. I totally understand that. But that had to be pretty exciting to pick up Harry Styles. In fact, I think you picked him up the night the magic mirror was stolen. So, man, that was crazy. There was a lot going on that night, huh? Yeah.
Yeah, I guess there was.
Yeah, so, what, did you see anybody that night, when, the mirror was stolen by chance?
I didn't see anything. Oh, I have to pull over real quick and make a stop, if I could.
Oh, okay, yeah, what, you gotta pick some up?
Yeah, I have to pick up some Fritos real quick. You just stay in the car and I'll be back, okay? I'll be back.
Oh, we got a runner! Flynn, tell me you're nearby. This guy's running, and he's a robot, and he's not wearing sandals, so I don't think I'm going to catch him. Tell me you got him.
Oh, I'm on it. I got this, partner. All right, Flynn. It's time to do some good. Let's do it. You there, criminal. Stop. Man down. That man is me. I'm very hurt.
Chopper! There was supposed to be a chopper. I'm supposed to get the chopper.
There is no chopper, punk. Why don't you take a seat, punk? You're under arrest, you punk.
Oh my God, Captain, you did it. Captain Wet Blanket, you did it.
Don't call me Captain Wet Blanket. Call me Velvet Thunder. Detective Sidewinder. Detective Deathblade. Put this man in cuffs so we can take him in and book him.
Oh my God, it's really happening.
This is the greatest thing that's ever happened. Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
Well, the Terminator admitted to stealing the mirror, and we recovered it. So, I guess this case is closed, gentlemen. Good job, detectives. I'd call that a job well done.
There's one thing that's still bothering me about this case, though, Captain.
What's that?
Why would the Terminator steal the mirror on his own? He had to be working for somebody, didn't he? I mean, didn't he?
I've actually had the same thought, Captain. I feel like the Terminator was probably working for somebody.
Yeah? That part wasn't lost on me either, gentlemen. I guess you need to keep working the case.
Oh, we will, sir. We will. We'll find out who's behind this whole thing.
I'd expect nothing less from you two. Get to it.
All right, Queen. We know you're probably the one who hired the Terminator to steal that mirror. You've done it before. What's to say you wouldn't do it again?
Are you serious? I had nothing to do with this. I took my shot during the paintball tournament. I'm not going to do it again. I'm certainly not going to hire the same fool who failed me the first time. Is that really what you think of me?
You really expect us to believe you had nothing to do with this?
Oh my goodness, yes, I had nothing to do with it. You know, this reminds me of that time I was in that barber shop quartet in Skokie, Illinois with Redfoot and Kobayashi. No one would ever give us the benefit of the doubt back then, either.
All right, Queen. If you say so, you're free to go for now. But we're going to keep our eye on you. Know that.
Keep both your eyes on me. I don't care. I'm innocent. Innocent, I tell you. I don't like being treated like this, either.
I don't know. What do you think there, partner? I really don't know. I think we should keep an eye on her. She has to know how close we got on this one, though, doesn't she? Yeah, I think she does.
Skokie, Illinois. Barbershop Quartet. Kobayashi. Redfoot.
Need a ride, Queen? Where to? Just drive, Jesus. Just drive.
Hey, Terminator. I heard you've been kicked out of Princesslandia.
That's right. They told me to get out, and they told me to not be back.
Did you get done what I wanted you to get done?
Yes, it's all been taken care of. So the man I want in the mirror, he's there?
The man you want in the mirror is there, and he's ready to answer all of your questions.
Excellent. That's great work, Terminator. I knew I could count on you. Now it's time to finish my plan.